And it's a historic day. In a few hours, India's biggest space adventure, a space mission, the mission to the moon, will reach its definitive moment. Will the Vikram lander be able to touch down successfully near the moon's south pole? Well, we'll know anytime after 2 a.m. on Saturday. Why is Chandrayaan so important? Why is this mission so important? Well, there are many reasons, but the four main reasons is the Chandrayaan will launch an intensive search for water on the moon after the first Chandrayaan mission detected water molecules, a historic find in itself. This mission explores a part of the moon where there's little global interest in, where there is global interest in future human missions, and it's a highly unexplored part of the moon. India hopes to become the fourth country in the world to soft land a probe on the lunar surface. And if this happens successfully, well, then it opens up the possibility of an Indian human mission to the moon. So it's going to be...
Having spent nearly 7 weeks in space, Chandrayaan 2, India's second moonshot, attempts a step India has never done before, attempting a very tricky soft landing on the moon.
Once the maneuver is started for landing from the 30 kilometer, it is landing on the surface of the moon, it takes 15 minutes. This 15 minutes travel of lander is new to ISRO. What happened is, if you are leaving the vehicle, it will fall like a football. This is a very, very complex process, and is new to us. Now, even for the people who are already done, every time it will be a complex process. And here we are doing first time, so that's what we told that is 15 minutes of terror. So it will be equal to sustaining the vehicle when it is coming there. It is holding, just like we are holding a baby and bringing it down. That holding activity function is done by the propulsion system. And we have the combination of four engines at the corner to bring down the Chandrayaan 2. But if the four engines are coming together, it may create a confusion. It will like a troubled water, like that you can create a lot of dust. For that only, at certain altitude, this engine will be switched off and we introduce a central engine.
So you named the lander Vikram. This is Vikram Sarabhai's centenary year. So it will be essentially like Vikram Sarabhai slowly lowering India's flag and India's rover onto the lunar surface, like a father bringing the baby down onto the lunar surface?
Maybe sentimentally you can tell like that.
But this is a tricky operation.
Yes, definitely it's tricky. That's what I told you. It is like suddenly somebody has come and give a newborn baby to your hand, whether you'll be able to hold it without the proper support. The baby will move this way, that way, but we should hold it. It's like that. The lander will go with this and all, but at the same time, it should be brought just like a baby.
Landing is especially difficult on the moon since the atmosphere is very thin and parachutes cannot be used to slow down the lander. The last country which attempted it was Israel and failed. Does that give you any heartburn or trouble?
No, not really. See, because we do realize the space technology and space activities is always fraught with a lot of ifs and buts. No matter what you have done, how much work you have done, there could always be surprises. But notwithstanding this, like we have been talking earlier also, our effort is to make the best of the preparation and then be prepared for the worst.
Historically, more than half the missions have failed while landing on the moon. Will Vikram rewrite history for India? India's Vikram lander going in for a landing on the lunar surface. A very tricky operation. Considered the 15 terrifying moments for ISRO and for the 1.3 billion Indians. Inside ISRO with camera person Govind, Pallav Bagla for NDTV.
All right, so those crucial 15 minutes. Now, India's Vikram lander is headed close to the south pole of the moon for that soft landing. So why has ISRO chosen this spot? NDTV science editor Pallav Bagla explains.
Laced with scientific instruments and national pride, the Vikram lander with the Pragyan rover headed towards the south pole of the moon, an unknown territory. The Chinese mission was the most northern to land, followed by the lunar missions. Most of the American lunar landing missions, including Apollo landings, were in the equatorial region. India hopes to explore the moon near the South Pole. But how difficult is it to go to the moon?
Going to the moon is difficult. Landing to the moon, it's not so easy. We saw a few weeks ago that an Israeli probe got some problems. And in addition, having a rover, it's not so easy. So it's a very ambitious mission.
After landing, the rover will carry out analysis of the lunar soil, and the lander will measure moonquakes and dig into the lunar crust, among other things. India will also continue its search for water on the lunar surface, since finding native water on the moon is critical for future habitation.
India's Chandrayaan 2 mission with its Vikram lander is going where no one has gone before, near the South Pole region of the moon. India exploring an uncharted territory of the moon. In Bangalore, with camera person Govind, Pallav Bagla for NDTV.
All right, so just to explain what really happens during those 15 minutes of terror, as they're being described by ISRO, when the Vikram lander will touch down on the south side of the moon, and also then the Pragyan rover will emerge. So take a look at how it will all pan out.
The Chandrayaan 2 began its journey atop the geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle Mark 3, or the Bahubali rocket, on July 22nd from Sriharikota. Having spent few weeks in the Earth orbit, it was then taken into the moon's embrace on August 20th after the tricky lunar capture operation. The spacecraft spent several days in the moon's orbit, where it stabilizes into a circular orbit passing over the poles. On specific instructions by ISRO, the Vikram lander and the orbiter separate. The orbiter continues its life studying the moon and keeping in touch with the Vikram lander. Soon, the Vikram lander with the Pragyan rover in its belly is lowered into a 100-kilometer by 30-kilometer orbit. Together, the orbiter and the lander carefully scan the landing spot. The lander starts its powered descent onto the lunar surface. The next 15 minutes are the most terrifying moments for the space scientist. Through programmed rough braking and fine braking maneuvers, the lander comes within touching distance of the moon surface. The best landing spot is zeroed in. The lander sets foot near the south pole of the moon. Once the lunar dust settles down, a few hours later, the ramp opens, displaying India's flag on the moon surface. Later, in a gentle operation, the Pragyan rover is rolled out onto the lunar surface. The Pragyan rover begins its slow moon walk. Etched on the rear wheels of the rover are the Ashok Chakra and the ISRO logo. India leaves an indelible and permanent imprint on the moon surface. Using an animation made and supplied by ISRO, Pallav Bagla for NDTV.
All right, and let's take a look at this tweet that was put out by ISRO just a short while ago, in which they put out an image and said, "We have the same wishes for Vikram orbiter. Want to stay in touch with Vikram and Pragyan as they make their way to the untouched lunar south pole and uncover its many mysteries. Well, then keep an eye out for the next edition of the Chandrayaan 2 Chronicles." And there they put out this cartoon, in a sense, in which it shows that the Vikram lander, they're having a conversation, in a sense. So that is what ISRO put out in its tweet just ahead of that moon landing. All right, well, let's go across to NDTV science editor Pallav Bagla, who's been tracking this entire mission. And Pallav, it now all boils down to what's going to take place at 1:55 a.m., those moments of terror, those 15 minutes of terror where, you know, we'll find out whether the mission will be a success. Of course, all of us are saying it's going to be a success. Nobody's even, considering the possibility. But tell us more about what's happening at ISRO. We know the Prime Minister is going to be there. School children have been selected from across the country to actually sit with the Prime Minister and watch that historic moment.
Certainly. ISRO is going about its job of putting the lander on the lunar surface with clinical precision. The Mission Control Center is monitoring the health of the orbiter, the lander, and the whole operation is being fine-tuned so that at 1:40 a.m. today, when the powered descent starts for the Vikram lander, and at 1:55 a.m. when the Vikram lander is expected to touch down near the south pole of the moon, everything goes on as per plan. Yes, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be in the Mission Control Center, and like he was there during the orbit insertion in Mars, I presume he will say, I will take the onus if something goes wrong. Remember, Gargi, this remains rocket science. More than 50% of the missions have failed on soft landing. While we and India pray for the success of the Vikram lander reaching the South Pole region successfully, but we should bear in mind this remains rocket science. And the Prime Minister is there to take accountability for whatever happens at that particular moment. The Prime Minister is a space buff. He knows how to use space technology for India. And he is going to be present with the scientists to both applaud and take responsibility for whatever happens. And there would also be these school children who have won an opportunity to share the stage with Prime Minister and the winning team of ISRO. So it is going to be in just over a little 12 hours from now, we would get to know what happens on the moon surface.